Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jumper.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. Say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today, a question sent in by Jason from Kentucky. And I have to give credit for this answer to Mike Alexander. Mike is my co-author on the Pivot Table Data Crunching books. Mike and I also do a three-day data analyst boot camp. The next one, Chicago, April 28th, 29th, and 30th of this year. So I picked this one up from Mike. Jason's question is, hey, I have five different worksheets here. They all have a pivot table. They all have a date up in the page area of the pivot table. They're all based on the same data set. I would like to be able to change the date on sheet one and have it change the page fields in sheets 2, 3, 4, and 5. And so we're going to record a tiny little macro, but then edit the macro. So we go to View, Macros, Record Macro. I'll call it Fix Pivot Table. I'm not going to assign it to a shortcut key because this is all going to happen automatically. So I start out on sheet 1 and I choose, let's just say February from the list, and then I go to sheet 2 and choose February, and then sheet 3 and choose February. Now, one of the reasons I'm recording each one of these is because it gets me the pivot table name for all of these different pivot tables. I'm going to need that. Click OK, and then in sheet 5, choose February. Click OK, and we'll stop recording. And then I want to go out and look at that macro. So we'll go to Visual Basic, and it should be on Module 1. Okay, so you can see that we're using a current page property, And basically, what I want to have happen is on sheet 2, I want to change the current page property to be equal to the value that I just selected on sheet 1. And back here on sheet 1, let's just take a quick look, it's in cell B1. So we're going to modify this macro a bit. We don't need to select the sheet. So I'll do sheet2.pivottables, pivot table 1, pivot fields date, current page. And instead of hard coding it to be February, I'm going to say worksheets sheet 1. Dot range B1 dot value. Okay, so that's the basic information there. There's a few extra things that the macro recorder recorded here that we don't really need. And basically, now that we have that line of code, we see that it's sheet 3, it's also called pivot table 1, sheet 4 called pivot table 1, sheet 5 called pivot table 1. You may not be that lucky. You may find that they all have different names. That's why we went through and recorded them that way. So I'm going to take this line of code, copy it, and paste it. So that way I can get to sheet 3, sheet 4, and sheet 5. Okay, and we also don't need the first line of code. All right. Now, I have these lines of code, but we'd have to go and run the macro every time, and that's not what I want to do. I'm going to copy these lines of code, Control-C to copy, and we're going to come back here to sheet 1, the sheet where the first pivot table is. And from the top left drop-down, select Worksheet, and from the top right drop-down, choose Pivot Table Update. This is a tiny little bit of code that's going to be run every time that we update that first pivot table. Press Control V, and what this says is every time we change the first pivot table, go through and change the other pivot tables. Let's give it a try. So we come back here to our tips and tricks. I'll go to sheet 1 and I will change this to be May. Click OK, and you don't see the screen flash or anything, but it actually did it. When we go check the other pivot tables, they are updating thanks to that macro. So, thanks to Mike Alexander for that cool tip. Mike and I have a lot of fun doing our three-day seminar. It's on Excel and Access. Think about that if you want to come to Chicago at the end of April. Thanks to Jason for sending in this question. Very common problem where you have multiple pivot tables. Change one page field and they'll all change using this method. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.